told the whole world how much we love Biafra, our beloved father's land. We love and cherish. We resold the whole world how much we love Biafra, our beloved father's land. We love and cherish. Biafra's story is the most touching and painful story in the world. Oh, Biafra's have been killing every day and night, but nobody is talking. Everywhere silent. We should be ashamed of ourselves. Hey, we said we are Christians, but we done nothing to help the Biafrans. When they are killing Biafrans, we done nothing to help them. Whether you help or not, we Biafran, we stand and protect our land, because we love Biafra and we will die for Biafra. Oh, we are Biafra, we are Biafra.
I respect people, but I'm not afraid of them. And I want to use this little opportunity to address those that say that they want to know where I come from. I, Prof. Alison Akoma, I come from town called Nenu in Obinwa, Abia State. And my mother come from Akwa Ibom. I'm a man that believe what my father used to say, Mberede nyini dike, Mberede ke jama dike, Mberede nyini onyesi na ya beze, Mberede ke jikwa na ameze. I so much believe in that word my father always used to say.
We love
Biafra. We are Biafra. We love Biafra. We show the whole world how much we love Biafra, our beloved father's land. We love and cherish. We show the whole world how much we love Biafra, our beloved father's land. We love and cherish. Biafra story is the most touching and painful story in the world. Oh, Biafras have been killing every day and night, but nobody is talking. Everywhere silent. Oh, we should be ashamed of ourselves. Hey, we said we are Christians, but we done nothing to help the Biafrans. When they are killing Biafrans, we've done nothing to help them. Whether you help or not, we Biafran, we stand and protect our land, because we love Biafra. We'll die for Biafra. Oh, we are Biafras. We are Biafras.
We love Biafra.
We love Biafra.
Our father's land.
Yeah.
We love and cherish.
We love and cherish.
We are Biafras.
We are Biafras.
We love.
So once again, fellow Biafrans, lovers of freedom, men and women of goodwill, people of conscience, wherever you are all over the world. As always, this is Radio Biafra Extra, and we are streaming live through Biafra Human Rights and Freedom Radio Station. Biafra Human Rights and Freedom Radio Station is being anchored by Diokba Uche Uka from Efo, who hails from Abatete in Anambra State, Biafra land. Diokba Uche Uka from Efo is the man who has simply assured us that he will not allow the heart of this project to see corruption. Most of you do not understand how important this project is to us. If we sit back and review what is at stake, you will understand the need why watchmen should never go to bed. You will understand the need why Biafran watchmen against all odds must stand to defend the Biafran nation in its last outpost. These were clear revelation Diokba Uche Uka from Efo saw before now. And he said, under my watch, I will not allow the heart of this project to see corruption. I do not expect everyone to understand the mindset behind these words, but one day you shall. By the special grace of the Creator, I remain George Onyebi. I call from Agbo. Agbo is in Anyoma Province. Anyoma Province is in Delta State. And Delta State is Biafra land. A every piece of land in Delta State. I will not fail to acknowledge men and women of honor in and out of the Biafra Restoration Project. Those who identify with us in our struggle and our challenge, because they clearly understand that the Biafrans remain the most endangered species of Homo sapiens here on Earth. We acknowledge your sacrifice, we acknowledge your presence and your ability to identify with us in a time like this. Every other pro-Biafran group who are sincerely fighting to restore Biafra, we acknowledge your sacrifice and our prayers are with you. Members of the de facto customary government, all of you who are involved in this movement, we understand the enormous sacrifice that is laid on your shoulder. They need to back down sometime, but believe me, you are doing the right thing and everything is working out the way it is divinely planned. We cannot be found wanting. Acknowledge all of you, men and women who stood their ground, doggedly defending the truth regarding the Biafra Restoration Project. I must acknowledge the indigenous people of Nnamdi-Kanu, because a day will come, they will regret their action. It is the truth that brought us here, and this truth must take us home. And those of you who are putting up criminality, those of you who are trying to divert attention, those of you who have been paid to bastardize this project, I tell you, you came late, you failed. We will fight you in an island you have not been before. We will fight you in an atmosphere where you will become a stranger. We will fight you till you will fight yourself. You are not a final consign to us. You are not our problem. But we see dangers we cannot compromise with. We see problem. We foresee doom that if we are not ready, we are gone as a people. And so what do? We have built and almost ready to go home. And one criminal come out from the blues and then want to make those who have paid the ultimate sacrifice, their labor to be in vain. And we say no. And of course, for some hours, we've been online trying to rectify one or two issues. Like I always say, we can always get better. The enemy will be there. We understand this. They will fight harder than we can even imagine. We know this. They are more connected and stronger than we are. And we are ready for them. This is one truth you can understand. Genuine Biafrans across the globe at this moment are mourning. They are weeping. They are crying. All they want, how do we save this nation? Some people are on Facebook talking about the war, the indigenous people of Nnamdi-Kanu, but the war is upon you already. It is upon you already. It is your cause to curse, so continue cursing. It is your cause to insult your father and your mother. So continue. Acknowledge your presence. Above all, let God be witness to all of us that it is the love of Biafra that brought us here. Nothing more, nothing less. At this moment, I want us to briefly consider some issues of utmost importance. Of course, this topic this morning, I entitled it, "Have you ever wondered what the Nigerian state really want from us?" A lot of things is going on. And out of desperation, they want something from us. And in ignorance, the Biafrans are chasing shadows and not asking critical questions in order to get genuine answer. They are robbing us. They're stealing our money. And they call us thief. They turn around and call us thief. Nigerians steals our oil and other natural resources. They call us criminals. They criminalize us. Nnamdi-Kanu is the one who stole our monthly due. Nnamdi-Kanu is the one who has duped many people taking advantage of our love for Biafra, yet is the one calling all of us criminal. But we shall see how it ends. Have you ever wondered what the Nigerian state really want from us? A lot of things are going on. Where our house is on fire, we are busy chasing rats. Some say they will fight to defend Biafra. And then they brought the war down to their doorstep. It is time we begin to consider the desperation for the Nigerian state. This is the only time we will begin to look for solution to secure the future of the next generation. If you cannot answer this question sincerely, we will be sitting here. These people understand what they want. This life as you know it today will not remain that way. And that is why we keep calling on communities of nations, the continent member nations that make up the Biafran. It doesn't matter whether you are a Ijaw, a Doma, a Gala, a Yala, you are the unprotected one. And if you fail to do something, I can assure you, the world as you know it today will not be as easy for your next generation, your children. People are desperate. They want our land by all means. Strategies have been mapped out. Even in their low estate, they have been able to come up with agenda, knowledge, wisdom, strategy, which can only be attributed to divinity. Let me try to clear you on that aspect before we move on. When a Biafran man wants to buy land, he buy a whole location. It could be in Abuja, it could be in Lagos. One Biafran man can buy the whole community. One way or the other, that is greatness, that is achievement, that is wealth. But you are alone. The day they will take this property from you, you will stand alone to fight for it, and you will lose it all. But when the Northerners, you call them mogul, you say they don't have sense. When they want to buy land from Biafra land, they make announcement, they gather their people. They expect more people to buy. It is better for them to buy 1 square meter than for one man to buy. And then you see, maybe if they have to buy 1 community from Biafra land. When you look at the CFO, you see that community they are buying belongs to over 3 million to 10 million people. And any day you stand up to look for this land, you will have 1 million people to fight. These are strategies way beyond our reasoning as a people of Biafra. Because why we are supposed to focus on ideology, when we are supposed to focus on principle, when we are supposed to focus on the things that will guarantee the safety of the next generation, when we want to be recognized, ego, we want to be supremacy. And I hope before our time is up, we are able to review these issues. I ask a simple question. Have you ever wondered why the Nigerian state, what they really want from us? What is all this desperation all about? And then those of you who are aiding and abetting them. Our life is gradually being taken from us. It is human and the earth. If they take the earth from you, they take your life and you do not exist. But if you save the land, you will have your life and everything will be as it was. Go back to the Bible and other religious book. Men of God do not fight for pounds and shillings, dollars, nor rubies. Men of God fought, they fought for land. Kings, kingdom, and throne were established for the sake of land. And if you lose your land, your people will suffer. It was a horrible experience that Abraham has to have a glimpse of the revelation that the children of Israel were going to suffer as a slave in a foreign land for 400 years. Sacrifice was made on behalf of that. At least after the suffering, they can't come home. Moses fought for promised land. David fought to defend the land of the people of God. And Solomon created institution to sustain the land of God. Prophets were there to tell them what is to come. It is all about the land. And we have found ourselves in the same position. The land of Biafra. But you cannot see it clearly, can you? We still control our land today. But we are gradually losing it. May I remind you that most communities in Biafra land, some ethnic nationalities, has almost finished selling their central land to strangers. And one day you will not be there, and your children will not have access to that land. But of course, the system is designed to make us sell them. A lot of evil is going on, but you have not been able to perceive it. Many communities have finished selling their central land. And when you talk to them, they say, forget about. But there are more beneath that the eye can see. You don't understand what is really going on. And of course, this morning, I will not digress further in order not to confuse you, but going back to the main issues. We have called for restructure in Nigeria. The Northerners say, no, we don't want restructure. The people of Biafra has called for vote collection by state. The Nigerian state say, no, the state cannot collect the VAT. We have gotten to the extent that they say they want ranching. No ranching. We told them we need ranching, no open grazing. The Nigerian state say no. There will be no ranching. In fact, it's ranching that they want in Biafra land. We told them about zoning or rational presidency. They said no. It has to be a no tenant. They have the landmass, that is what they tell you. They have the population, that is what they told you. Even considering the fact that the first census organized in Nigeria was rigged by the British government who gave us Nigeria. We talk about creation of state police. The Nigerian state said no. They said, no, nothing like creation of state police. We went on to ask for true federalism, if there were anything like true federalism. The Nigerian state said, no. We moved on to ask for electronics transmission. Of election. They said no. We talk about declaration of Boko Haram as a terrorist group. They said no. Boko Haram is not a terrorist. They are misguided brothers. I just asked a question this morning. Have you ever wondered what these people really want? Despite the criminality of IPONC, Nnamdi Kanu criminality. Everybody know, as at the initial stage, we are not terrorists, but we know where they are going to. We talk about anti-open grazing law. They say no. It will not work in Nigeria. We talk about cattle tax. They said it's a crime against Mohammed, but yet they forbid beer, but they enjoy the resources, the tax coming from drinking of beer and kankai. We talk about national conference. The few one they try to put up just to deceive the people of Nigeria is a story for another day. They said no. We have been singing about a referendum or plebiscite as the case may be. They said no. The Nigerian state, I must tell you, when you talk about regional self-rule, they said no. We have called for constitutional review. The Nigerian state said no. We said then give us Biafra Republic. They said it's not possible. You can't have it. And then all that scheme agitating, yearning for Oduduwa Republic. The Nigerians said no. The Middle Belt region came and said they want their own region. Nigerians said no. You talk about social media freedom. Nigerians said no. The issue of Twitter is still lingering. Nigerians said no. We must shut you down. And so have you ever wondered, what do they want? Because the last time I checked, they are the owner of the oil blocks in our land. The last time I checked, they control the three arms of government, legislature, executive, and the judiciary. And the last time I checked, every security apparatus is being controlled by them, from the naval to the aviation to the artillery. They practically control all of them. We talk about the judicial system, and they are the attorney general, they are the chief justice, and every other thing you can think of. And so what do they want? They control our land. We properly understand that there are bills on the floor of Senate, which is being systematically presented to take over that which matters to all of us, the land of Biafra. But if you have to look at it from the other way around, they want our land, yes. They want the land. That is why they keep campaigning. What do they call it? Grazing Reserve Bill, cattle ranching, open grazing, to mention but a few. Yes, they want our oil. They controlled it already. Mrs. Alakija, a Yoruba woman, happens to be the richest black woman alive. I mean, by own and all you well in Bayasa. And then here there is another one, the richest man in Africa, Dangote, who owns a refinery, and there is no oil in his community. If we move on, they want our VAT. To collect our VAT, they say yes to it. They pass a bill even without consideration or any other thing. They want it. You talk about presidency, yes, they want the presidency. You talk about the issue of insecurity, yes, they love insecurity. Do you know the number of killing, the magnitude of killing taking place in Nigeria? It will shock all of you. And so for those of you calling for war, it is upon you already. And when you talk about this insecurity, it's amazing. They want it because they can make money from the dead. If you look at every sector, starting from IPONC, each time they have opportunity to take Nigerian government to any newspaper court, what you hear them say, we see you giving up 1 billion for those who've died. Did you die? Did your family member die? It's the money you cash out from the dead. And our people who fail to reason, you will join the dead. and somebody like China Samuru will cash out from you. But they are not my concern this morning. I'm asking the Nigerian state. I'm asking the people of Biafra. Just a historical question. Have you ever wondered what they want from us? Gradually, everything that was the terms and condition of supposedly the amalgamation of 1914 is taken from us, and we are here. On social media, ramping and jumping up and down, pretending we know it all. And those of you in diaspora, can you come home? And those of you at home, are you truly your indigenous of your community anymore? Some of you, you are from that community, but it ends with you. If there is no government to put policies in place that will protect you in the nearest future, your generation shall be vagabond upon this earth. And this will not happen to generation of Biafra. We have wandered enough. We have suffered enough. And so those who can discern, those who can perceive, those who understand what we are trying to make you see at this moment, must rise up. You must rise up. There is no excuse. There is no excuse. You must rise up. You must get involved, because it will take all of us to save all of us. Politicians today who are reigning and shining, understand people like Dan Etete. He was one time financial minister, or what do they call them? Very wealthy. His house in Port Harcourt, when he finished building the house around Javinik, he bought a lion as a pet for the security pet for the house. And I remember the last time he was sighted in UK, he was on a public bus with all the weight he amassed for himself. That is us in Port Harcourt, the last time I checked. It is Okada riders and Keke Napepe riders that live there. It's a dilapidated building already, but this was built by millions. I know so many of them, I do not mean to disrespect them. And so today you can build mansions. Two generations after yours, it will look as if you never existed. But it is your sacrifice, genuine one. It is your actions this day that will be backed by the Creator Himself. And generation who know nothing about you, your name will be on their lips forever. We understand the reason why we are ready to risk everything. It is not because we want to be remembered, because of what benefit it is. But if the history of the world ever be told, that men stood to fight evil in a time like this, they will talk about us. And so we call upon you, good people of Biafra, do not keep quiet. Do not be discouraged. Do not pretend all is well because all is not well. It cannot be well inside the well. Get that straight. The career freedom fighters are making hell a lot of money out of us. But of course, they are feeling the wave. But if you can be kakwane be, as you go to church, ask yourself simple question. As you go to your mosque, as you go to Minala, Robotarian Arabatera, ask yourself a simple question. What do they want from us? And if these people are this desperate to take that which does not belong to them, my brother, we are more desperate to make sure we'll protect that which belongs to us. They cannot take it from us. And so why would sojourn on this mystic island called Biafra? Why will battle to bring an end to this evil? You must choose your side. You must get ready to defend the defendless. And one day, just the same way it happened in Abuja, they will call on all of you and said, according to the government of Nigeria, so government has violated and has done, just give you one grammar and they take your life from you. We need to be ready. Whenever, however, we have no intention to undermine anybody, but I think we must prepare to go. This is the far I intend to go this morning regarding this issue. And of course, at this moment, our WhatsApp line is open. Our lines are open. Let us see how it goes. It does depend on your time zone. And if you have any contribution to make, a positive and genuine one, I must tell you. The numbers to call is, the direct line is 080, or rather 081-221-5297. 081-221-5297. That is the number to call. And of course, I repeat again, the direct line is 081-221-5297. And our direct line is 070-815-45642. Our direct line once again is 070-815-45642. Feel free to call in and make your contribution. It's just a rhetorical question, and I need you to ask yourself and answer the question if possible. Have you ever wondered what the Nigerian state want from us? And have you ever wondered why the people of Biafra constantly cry, complain about marginalization, about oppression, about emasculation? Have you ever wondered? Our life is not as bad as you think. There is something we've not been able to figure out. And we will help you get there. And of course, this having been said, the Biafra Nation Alliance, the de facto customary government, and all the pro-Biafran group who understand the need to continue to push till Biafra is restored must not relent, because a lot is at stake. The lines are open and you are free to call in and make your contribution. And of course, the people of Biafra must continue to ask themselves this question. What does the Nigerian state want from us? What do they want? And if our life, which is our land, is what they want, what do we do? The sun will surely rise again. I'll be back in a minute.
I learned from long ago what matters most in life, and now I think I know why one will fight to death when people rise against the helpless just for greed. They'll hope it lasts for long, but just in dawn of time, the sun will rise at last, and darkness goes to bed. The night may rise and fall, but light will stand out tall. Some people might believe that one can fight with this. When fighting gets tough day, then freedom will not come. In case you want to know what freedom fighting is, then I guess you'll have to go and search real freedom, man. rise and fall, but light will stain out all. The sun will rise at last, and darkness goes to bed. The dreams of yesterday will live on in our minds. In this our quest we know that men will rise and fall. When they try once and fail, they'll retreat and succumb. A voice from shadows say, son, heed this wake-up call. Strive hard to stand defeat, rise instant to your feet. Cause the sun will rise at last, and darkness goes to bed. The night may rise and fall, but light will stand out tall. Yes, the sun has risen, so the dark will have to go. The stars that glitter glow, we shine for then you know, yeah.
Of course, if you cannot access our studio line this morning and you have access to my private social media platform, it could be the WhatsApp or any other private media platform, you are free to call in. We will not be wasting so much time on this program, but the people of Biafra must continue to ask themselves this question, and they must be ready to give themselves genuine answer. This is Biafra Human Rights and Freedom Radio Station. Our mission is simple. No more lies. Nobody will be allowed to sell the next generation of Biafra. And of course, for record purposes, we have our FM radio station in Anambra State. You must endeavor to have access to that platform. Our people are on ground gathering information to know those who are behind the shedding of innocent blood in Anambra State. Of course, with proper evidence. You turn into 100.5 FM. You can get it all the way from Delta State to Obawosa and Zene Junction, down to Onitsha Head Bridge, and of course, Ogbaru, Mpo, Opiweka, Territory, and its environment. And then in River State, within Obiakpo and Ikoli local government, areas like Neka, some areas in Igirita, Rukpoko, down to Rumodumanya, of course, within Rumokoro Aziz, down to Rumomo, Rumogbo, Rumorosie, and the rest of them. You can get Biafra Human Rights and Freedom Radio Station on 100.5 FM. We are on satellite, we are on Facebook, and of course, we are on Simple. Where you are around the world and identify yourself with them. Don't let anybody deceive you. This war is upon us already. Just that is a complicated one. We have to fight ourselves. We have to fight the enemy. And we have to survive above all. Don't let them deceive you. If you can read the handwriting on the wall, you will understand that what they want has been clearly given what they want. And so we have a choice to make. To be hunted down like animal without anybody. somebody speaking up for us or to organize ourselves and get ready for the inevitable. And of course, I will be winding down shortly if you are not able to assess the line. Of course, I'm talking to reasonable human beings. I'm not talking to the indigenous people of Nanda Kanu. I'm not talking about the Nigerian state. Their issues doesn't bother me because we already know the truth. We already know the truth. All we are trying to do is to survive. Is to survive. We already know how it's going to end. And so we have to inform our people. We have to enlighten our people. We have to let them see the truth. We must prepare them for what is to come. Because if we fail to, I do not know where we will be when we close our eyes in death. But there will be so much regret. And those of you who have been able to see beyond ordinary vision, doing what is necessary, you must stand your ground. You must stand your ground even unto the end. A lot of atrocity is going on, but sometimes we begin to wonder who is actually responsible for the carnage going on in Biafra land. The people of Biafra, genuine people of Biafra, must make sure that they stand their ground till the end. Our lines are still open, and you are free to call in if you can be able to access the line. There is survival, and we understand that clearly. Many people will pay. Many people will die. Many people will suffer. But if we are able to organize ourselves, this issue can be managed. This having been said, I will have to wind up at this moment. We continue from where we stop. Your France must get ready for what is to come. Because it's not over until it's all over. I want to say good morning from here. Even as I sign off, I can only ask for the blessing of the Creator upon your life. We continue pushing until we get home. And for your information, we are Biafra Watchmen. We remain Biafra Watchmen. And by the special grace of God, we are not going anywhere until we get home. And so this moment, I will sign off. And then we'll continue from there later in the day. Have you ever wondered, would the Nigerian state truly want from the people of Biafra? Have you ever wondered? Goodbye, and God be with you.
Yes.